suit that's actually paint. You are naked. That's all paint. Yeah. Which is crazy. All right, but before we get to that, let's talk about the loss of this. I mean, everyone expected you to win. I expected you. The world expected you to win. So going into it, what was different? Like, were you? Did you feel good going in, or was there something different this time?
It's always crazy going into every fight, you know? It's always so much chaos and so many things going on. And things weren't perfect. They never are. And I think the one thing that was different was it was my third title fight in 9 months. And I don't think anyone's ever even attempted that before. And
that's a lot.
Yeah, but I don't make any excuses or anything like that. I've fought in worse conditions. But I think the one thing that was different, I just kind of felt tired. But other than that, I've been more tired, I guess.
So when you get hit that hard, what happens to you? Like, do you feel it at the time, or there's so much adrenaline you don't feel it?
Well, I got clipped in the first exchange. So I was knocked out of my feet like the first time I got hit, and
that must have surprised you.
Well, it's hard to really know what's going on, and so in that first hit, I cut open my whole mouth and I knocked my teeth loose. And, you know, guys fight for five-minute rounds. They're teeth-knocking each other's faces the whole time, and nothing like that happens. It was just destiny. It had to go down that way. And it was weird. I had, like, no perception of, like, I felt like almost like I couldn't see. Like, I could see, but I couldn't tell, like, how far my hand was from my face or how far she was from me. Like, when you sit and you're not moving and you still are aware of where your body is, that's, like, a part of your brain that's telling you where you are in space. And it was like that kind of turned off. I was like swinging blindly. I knew she was out there, but like it was, I really don't remember most of that.
That must have been really scary then, because you're aware that that's happening, and also that's like in a split second, you're aware of that and you're still trying to protect yourself.
Well, you're aware of that and you have to try and not make it appear as if you're hurt.
Right.
Because if someone can tell, then they're going to swarm in on you. And so I was trying my best to make it, to kind of hide the fact that I wasn't even there anymore.
So do you have, how long does a headache last after you're hit like that? Do you have a headache still?
No. I don't know. I don't have a headache at all. It's not about, like, pain or things happening. It's just things stop working, you know? Like my brain stopped working properly, and my teeth didn't really work that properly.
And how long was it that your brain was not aware of that? How long did that take to settle down?
Probably till, like, the next morning.
Wow. Did you worry for a minute? Like, could this be permanent? Did I really hurt myself, and maybe I won't do this again?
No, to be honest, like, what I was thinking, like, my thought, I was like, in the medical room, and I was, like, down in the corner, and I was like, what am I anymore if I'm not this? And I was literally sitting there, like, thinking about killing myself in the exact second. I'm like, I'm nothing. I'm like, what do I do anymore? And no one gives a shit about me anymore without this. And, to be honest, I looked up, and I saw my man, Travis, was standing there, and I was looking up at him, and I was just like, I need to have his babies. I need to stay alive. That was, like, what I was thinking. Like, I was meant to have him when I was at my lowest, for sure.
Yeah.
I don't know if I would have made it without him.
To have that support system, sure. It breaks my heart to hear, anybody looking at you, you're such a brave woman in so many ways, and so obviously strong physically and mentally to do what you do. So to hear you say that, I actually think it's a really great thing, and I'm grateful that you did say that, because there are a lot of people out there that have thoughts like that, and they're looking at you going, wow, she can have thoughts like that. So you just did a lot of good for a lot of people. So thank you for saying that.
I did a lot of thinking. I'm like, why did this happen? Why did it happen like this? Because I do believe, like, all the best things from the worst things. Every worst thing that happened in my life resulted in the absolute worst thing, as a result of the absolute best things. And I'm trying to think, like, what is the reason of all this? And I'm thinking, like, what my actual purpose is, and maybe just winning all the time isn't what's best for everybody. And I felt like maybe my role is, everyone has their moment of picking themselves off the floor, and I've gone through several of mine, but no one had actually seen me go through it, and maybe I just had to be that example, picking myself off the floor. for everyone. Maybe that's what I'm meant for. And I really do believe I'm still undefeated, because being defeated is a choice. Everybody has losses in their life, but I choose to always be undefeated.
So you're going to fight again, clearly, that's what you're saying. And who do you want to fight next?
Of course I want to fight Holly.
Right.
I'm a beater.
So Holly's going to fight somebody else next, and so I'm assuming you want Holly to beat that person so that no one else beats Holly.
Right, so I want to be the one to
Right,
beat
okay, so poor Holly, look out. I mean,
I don't feel bad for her at all.
Yeah. Well, listen, I think you're amazing, and you know that. I told you that last time you were here, but you just won me over even more. I think showing vulnerability and showing that just because you're strong doesn't mean you have a soft side and a vulnerable side, and I think it's important to have both. You can't, if you're just strong, you're not a human being. We all have everything that you're showing, so thank you for showing that. We have to take a break. We'll